We're going to a fast-paced show today. Let me see. So we're going to start the show out with Senator Mark Montigny, who's going to make an endorsement here in the Democratic primary for our lieutenant governor. Then we're going to have that candidate on following Mark. And then around 10:35-ish or so, we'll have Congressman Keating for a brief. He's going to give us a call. And then we will have in the next hour for a little bit, we will have Jeff Deal, Representative Jeff Deal, who's running for the U.S. Senate. Of course, the primary is on September 4th. That's this coming Tuesday, regardless of whether you're a Democrat or a Republican. And certainly, if you're unenrolled, you can vote in either one of those, but only one of those primaries. So without further ado, I want to introduce our friend, Senator Montigny. Good morning, Mark. How are you?
Hey, Chris. How are you?
I'm doing really, really well. So you wanted to make a... Your supporters know who you're supporting here in the lieutenant governor race. Who is that, Senator Montigny, and why?
First, I want to give you a hard time. I notice on all these big networks and cable stations that all the senior, highly paid folks get the day off, you know, before Labor Day weekend. They all have these blowhards filling in for, like, you know, you name your favorite radio or TV personality, and yet you're there on this beautiful day. What happened?
Not only am I here, well, first of all, I'm low, man. Second of all,
that was my implication, but I wanted you to say it.
No. Second of all, I'll be here Labor Day. I actually work all the holidays that I can, Mark. Where else would I rather be than working on Labor Day? And if you can, by the way, Senator, as you know, this isn't really work.
No, if you could move the station down a little bit further, where you spend a lot of time out there, where the sea is blue and the breeze is beautiful.
Mm-hmm.
You know exactly where I mean. If you could move it there, I would suggest that you don't deserve pay for it. I would say it should be volunteer time.
I don't think I deserve to be paid, but I don't want to tell that to management ever. This is such
I'll be happy to tell them.
This is, wait, I thought you were for the working man, Mark.
Wait a minute, you're a conservative talk show host.
So, you know, some say less and less, so.
Who does a fabulous job, by the way, except when I disagree with you, which is, I don't know, I'd say 75%. No, who knows? Why am I putting a percentage on it when now you'll have people tabulating?
Right. That's true. That's true. So we have a... we have you to thank for coming here on the show, but the guy who really has you to thank is who? Who are you here for today, Mark, on this beautiful day?
Well, let me tell you what I'm doing. I'm a little bit leery of the word endorsement because I think that people don't really like to be told who to vote for. So over the years, I've done it sparingly, and there have been times when some of my supporters have said, what the hell did you do that for? There have been other times when we've supported somebody who I thought was good for the region, and I also thought, frankly, that it was good for me politically, because I have to think about what works for me as I serve a constituency. But when you represent 170,000 people, you also should be careful about how you throw that around. So I'm careful to say, because I get asked very frequently by supporters, who are you voting for in X race? And sometimes I say, and other times I don't, frankly. There are many times when I simply say, Chris, like everyone else, there's a reason why the ballot box is private. So I'm going to vote today with my mom because it's just easier for her at 93, as strong as she is, and she might be listening, so I'll be in a lot of trouble. She likes your show. I'll be in a lot of trouble just for bringing her up. But because she thinks Jimmy Tingle is such an interesting guy, I think I won't be looking at her ballot, by the way, but I'm hopeful that I'll be able to at least convince her, although usually she tends to do the opposite of what I do. But I remember Jimmy Tingle from way back in the SMU days, which, of course, that's not a reason in and of itself to endorse, but I think he's got a very unique connection to this region. I think he's got a very interesting life story. I mean, you know, from growing up in the rough and tumble ways right up to the Kennedy School in 60 Minutes. He's known as a funny guy, and frankly, on a light note, I think he's one of the funniest guys certainly that I've ever met. And I met Jay Leno, too, by the way. Tingle's funnier.
Wow.
But other than my brother and my father, and now my four-year-old son, not because my son is a comedian, but because everything he says makes me smile. So other than that, Tingle's pretty good at bringing the smiles out. But that's not all he is. I mean, people get, you know, sometimes pigeonholed, particularly when they're a celebrity. But you've had him on your show, and it's great that you were able to get him today, because I won't discuss. It's not like I am a surrogate to discuss his platform. I'm simply telling my supporters that when I go to the ballot box today, I'm voting for Jimmy Tingle as lieutenant governor. I'm also voting for my good friend John Saunders, who's on the ballot. So usually I don't make a public display of it, but every once in a while I do, and today is one of those days.
We're speaking to Senator Mark Montigny from New Bedford. He's voting, telling us who he's voting for. He's voting for John Saunders for county commission, the Democrat primary, and he's voting for Jimmy Tingle for lieutenant governor. Yeah, I think Mark, though, your point about him, you and he both went to SMU, now known as UMass Dartmouth. I think that is a unique connection to the area and would benefit us in a lot of ways having him up there talking about that, right?
Well, yeah, and again, if that were his only point on the resume, it certainly wouldn't attract me enough. But right away for me, given where I grew up and my educational background and the struggles that my family had to go through to put the four of us through undergraduate, I automatically will look at somebody from SMU or the state system first and say, what's in their value system, what's in their background that relates to the region that I represent. Now, it doesn't mean that's the only qualification, and if I thought he was inept in other ways, I wouldn't consider it. But he's a smart, progressive, practical guy who also happens to be famous and funny, which you could say, well, how is that relevant? Well, of course it's relevant. You have to be able to communicate. You have to be able to handle the stage. You have to be able to motivate people. You have to be able to drive crowds. He's been doing it since he was a kid, and he's got a good brain to go with it. So, I mean, the one thing I'm offended by is Matt Damon. Obviously, it's like tail wagging the dog. Matt Damon must have got wind of me endorsing him, and he beat me to the punch.
That's right, because for folks who don't know, actually, Mark reached out to me a week ago to do this, just that Jimmy Tingle's mother passed away. It was kind of been a tough little bit segment of time here for Tingle, so we weren't able to put the whole piece together. But this was before Matt Damon endorsed Jimmy Tingle.
That shows my courage.
Mark,
I got to tell you one funny story.
Sure.
You mentioned, you were talking yesterday, I don't know if you've seen it, but did you see the Jimmy Tingle piece with Larry David? Have you seen that?
The movie?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. It's a funny, funny movie.
Well, I haven't seen it, but I have to tell you my one Larry David story. I'm being a rubber-necking name dropper here. So I'm in Oak Bluffs one day with my girlfriend, or I should say ex-girlfriend, Kelly Manchester, who, by the way, Howie Carr called hot and young. I would be much more comfortable describing her as intelligent and beautiful. But anyway, she was a big Larry David fan, and we're sitting there, and she spots him, because he spends a lot of time, as you know, on the Vineyard, and she spots him, and I said, that's not Larry David. But at the time, I would have thought he was Bernie Sanders if I had known Bernie Sanders as well. And so I'm thinking, how do I get a chance for her to meet him without looking like a clown trying to, you know, bother a famous person on a busy Oak Bluffs stretch? And right. So she walks straight up to him. He completely ignores me. He might as well have looked at me and said, beat it, pal. And she and he end up playing, what's that little game with a dollar bill, liar's poker?
Really?
And she kicked his butt. And he was so fun and approachable, but mainly because of her. I mean, like I said, I was sort of like, in the Peanuts cartoon where all the adults, you know, can't really talk. They just want one. He just turned his back and played liar's poker with her. But I thought he was one of the funnier people that I've ever listened to. Although I think Jimmy Tingle, he's got nothing on Jimmy Tingle.
Well, and of course, it was Clear History is the movie with Jimmy Tingle is in with Larry David. And also, of course, our friend Chuck Leonard, His Mr. Cesspools make an appearance in that movie as well.
Only Chucky Leonard could pull that off.
Only Chucky Leonard could somehow star.
Actually, his wife probably pulled that off.
It's probably the same situation, right?
Lisa did all of the business and legwork on that.
She probably ended up playing liar's poker as well with Larry David. Well, Chucky's
doing it. I knew that I was irrelevant as soon as he had his eyes on Kelly Manchester.
We're speaking with Senator Mark Montigny about his endorsement today of both County Commissioner John Saunders and of that he's voting for Jimmy Tingle and he's voting for John Saunders. So, Mark, I'm going to let you go. I know you have a busy schedule in front of you, but we'll have to get you in here because I know you had a pretty successful legislative session to talk about some of the things that you got done.
Yeah, we got a lot done, and of course I'm frustrated by the things that don't get done, and I like to bark about those too because maybe we can motivate people to to push some reps and senators to move on stuff. So we should do that after Labor Day.
Yeah, excellent, excellent. Well, Mark, thanks again for giving us a shout and give your best to your mother for us.
One last thing I want to say, Chris, because I don't take anything for granted. So I'm on the ballot, and I appreciate the support and ask for the vote. Didn't intend to do that this morning because I'm unopposed, but I just don't take it for granted. I look at it as a privilege to serve, and in some ways a privilege to be on the ballot unopposed. Some people don't like it or agree with it, but I still don't take the vote for granted. So I hope people will take the time on Tuesday, no matter who you're voting for. It is a primary. It's important. If you can get out, you should on the 4th. Or there are absentee ballots right through 5 o'clock today at your city or town halls.
Excellent. Hey, thanks a lot, Senator Montigny. Appreciate it.
Take care.
Have a great day. That was Senator Mark Montigny. Appreciate him making some time for us this morning. Look, you know, it's not often that people do endorse people anymore, and particularly Democrat ticket's going to have a hard time this year against, I keep on to call him Bill Weld, but it's really Charlie Baker. So I thought it was newsworthy that Senator Montigny would, you know, put himself out there to endorse a guy who went to school here locally, Jimmy Tingle, who's a Democrat running for lieutenant governor. I thought that was newsworthy, right? That's why I brought it to you. Tell you what we're going to do. We'll take a very quick break. And when we get back, we will have, in a few minutes, Jimmy Tingle, the running for lieutenant governor, who Mark Montigny just spoke fondly of. But we will take a very quick break here on 1420 WBSM.